By the time of the raid on Polis Massa, the men of the 501st were starting to get a little sick of the so-called rebellion. In the past, we'd secretly enjoyed putting down a local insurrection or two. They kept the troops sharp and the Empire feared. But these rebels were different. They were organized, they were growing, and they were everywhere. The raid on Polis Massa was a perfect example of how things were starting to fall apart. We were supposed to go in, wipe out a small band of rebels, and recover some stolen Imperial plans on an encrypted holodisk. Before we knew it, we were nearly overrun by rebel forces, with the holodisk nowhere to be found.
Lord Vader wants this raid done by the book. Our first objective is the comm center, just beyond this hangar. Executed troops. Now it's time to make our way to the base command building on the far side of the facility. If our intelligence is right, along the way we'll find a rebel holodisk containing some very important plans.
Roger that. Copy that. Crush the scum! Burbag. Nice spinning, trooper!
Take time to realign the comm dish and transmit the data from the holodisk. You'll have to hold off the rebels until the transmission is complete. Do not let the comm facility fall into enemy hands.
Rebel, take them out!
Caverns of this complex. The rebels have a data bank that holds Imperial encryption codes that can be used to eavesdrop on our ship-to-ship communications. Make your way to the caverns and destroy the data bank.
What?
I've got good news and bad news. The good news is it's time to get off this dreary rock. The bad news is the rebels have taken over the hangars. You'll have to fight our way out.
Roll down!
Our raid is a success, and even though the holodisk didn't have the plans we're looking for, it will lead us to someone who does.
Even though the Polis Massa raid was only a partial success, we finally had a lead on the whereabouts of the Death Star plans, which suited the 501st just fine. With the information gathered on Polis Massa, Vader concluded that the stolen plans had been given to Princess Leia Organa of Alderaan. We weren't surprised. For all their talk of being a peaceful planet, Alderaan had been thumbing its nose at the Empire for years. After a brief and pointless battle, we boarded the ship, the Tantive IV, over Tatooine, began looking for the plans, and waited for Lord Vader's arrival.
Lord Vader has tracked the stolen Imperial plans to Ambassador Organa. Retrieve the plans and bring the Ambassador to Lord Vader. Alive.
Take cover!
To the tech room. We'll need to take out the security mainframes on the bridge before we can gain access to the rest of the ship.
Watch your flank.
Escape pod areas. Make your way to the engine room and retrieve them from the security terminal on the second floor.
Taking you down, laughing boy.
Disable the turbine to clear our way to the terminal. Take the access code to the tech room terminal. Nice work. Now let's clear those rebels out of the escape pod bays and secure the rest of the ship. Princess Leia must be captured before she can escape.
you a little short for a stormtrooper?
The day is ours. Well done, gentlemen.
After Lord Vader took custody of Princess Leia, we all figured it was just a matter of time before she coughed up the plans. Many of us had been unwilling witnesses to Vader's powers of persuasion in the past. The thought of a pampered little princess resisting his terrible will was inconceivable. When the Death Star was destroyed, about half of the 501st Legion was still in the hangar getting into their ships. Of those who made it out, another third were caught in the explosion. I'd fought with some of those men for over 20 years. Afterwards, those of us that survived hooked up with a nearby Imperial fleet making a retaliatory strike on the Rebels' base on Yavin 4. It wasn't the best thought-out plan, but we were cut off from our leaders, tired and operating on instinct. If not for our training, we probably would have never gotten past their orbital defenses.
Scramble reinforcements! Repeat! Scramble all reinforcements!
Their heavy transports are trying to go around us. Destroy them before they can jump to hyperspace.
Well done, Lieutenant.
Destroy them. Their frigates are harassing our fighters. Show them no mercy.
Watch it. Fighter on your tail.
To make the jump to hyperspace, they'll rip right through us. Clear their fighters out and be quick about it. We haven't any time to spare.
Well done, Lieutenant.
Well done, pilots. clear a path for our frigates to cover you. Use a TIE bomber to destroy their heavy turrets.
Beginning my attack run.
Those engines, men. They can't jump if they haven't any engines.
Attention all pilots! Attention all pilots! Prepare for takeoff!
Aft engine overheating!
Ours, men. Dispatch the 501st to the planet's surface. Yavin 4 will fall before the day is done.
And so the battle over Yavin came to an end. I'm told we destroyed hundreds of rebel ships that day. Even if it had been thousands, it wouldn't have made up for the Death Star. By the time we landed on Yavin, whatever shock we'd felt at the destruction of the Death Star had been replaced by anger. For months, we treated the rebellion like a disobedient child, only to be repaid for our tolerance with treachery on an unimaginable scale. Frankly, I don't remember much of the fighting. I guess we won.
Okay, you all know the mission. The Rebel base is located in that ancient temple over there. Our first job is to take the Rebel command post located in the ruins of that stone fountain just ahead. Our next objective is to capture the command post under the viaduct. Gather your forces. It'll be a tough slog. Now rush the reflecting pool. It will make a good staging area for the assault of the temple. Counterattack could start at any second. Defend the reflecting pool with all your might. well defended. Now it's time to breach the security door on the temple. A unique breaching bomb has been left at the point marked on your map. Retrieve the bomb from its drop-off location and place it near the temple security door. The bomb has a 10-second timer, so you better start running as soon as you set it. Decapitate the rebel command. Vengeance is ours, men. The spirits of our fallen brothers will sleep soundly tonight.
After the battle, the surviving members of the 501st finally caught their breath. The Empire had taken the rebels' best shot and come up standing. Now, it was our turn to strike. No one ever complained about the cold on Hoth. We never felt it. Even though we were blinded by blizzards, we could see the final end of the rebellion in our blaster sights. Was it only a mirage, perhaps? But on that day, on that planet, our blood ran hot with dreams of victory, melting the ice that stood in our way.
There is no tomorrow, men. Today we crush the rebellion once and for all. You know the orders. Destroy the shield generator in preparation for Lord Vader's arrival. Next, focus all efforts on preventing the final transport ship from lifting off. We'll begin by taking over their Outlook command post. Move out.
He's coming around.
Bunker. attack on the shield generator. The Assats will take point on the attack. Protect them at all costs.
Watch those blasters!
Trooper!
Take out the security console in the command center to gain access to the back hangar. We must destroy the final trunk before it can escape. Excellent work, Lieutenant. I'll inform Lord Vader. Strike beacon has been placed in the hangar for you. Acquire the beacon and place it under the transport ship. Command will use the coordinates from the beacon to launch a massive attack from above. Failure is not an option. Excellent. Now protect the beacon while we lock in your current position. Momentarily.
As the rebels fled, the 501st gathered around a burning bunker and let out a cheer that shook the stars. The rebellion was done. The Death Star was being rebuilt bigger than ever. Order had finally returned to the galaxy. In no small part due to the efforts of the fighting men of the 501st.